invite our boys and girls to come on up here to the front, and you can find a seat right here. Come on up, and you can have a seat on the floor right here in front. Okay, so if you were here for Sunday school, do you remember what our refrain was today?
No.
No? Oh. Well, let's see. I'll help you out. It was, you can trust in God's promises. Do you guys remember the actions for that? No. Oh, you're being silly. Here, I'll help you out. And as Pastor Bobby discovered today, it's really hard to do the actions with a mic, so I'm going to set this down. We're going to learn how it's really true that we can trust in God's promises from the story of the birth of John foretold. So I'm going to read this story for you guys. And this comes from Luke 1, the first chapter. Okay, Pax, you need to listen. In the days of Herod, king of Judea, there was a priest named Zechariah. And he had a wife from the daughters of Aaron. Her name was Elizabeth. They were both righteous before God. They kept all the commandments of the Lord, but they had no child, for they were both old. Now Zechariah was serving as priest before God. He was chosen to enter the temple of the Lord. There he burned incense. A large group of people were praying outside, and there appeared to him an angel of the Lord. The angel stood on the right side of the altar, and Zechariah was afraid when he saw him. So let's take a look at our picture here. Which one's the angel? Yeah, that guy. Which one's Zechariah? Yep, that's right. Which one's the angel? Oh, yep, that's right. And which one's Zechariah? Yeah, you got it right. So an angel appeared in Zechariah. He was pretty afraid. He wasn't expecting to see the angel there. It gave him quite the fright. But the angel said, "Do not be afraid. Your prayer has been heard. Your wife Elizabeth will have a son, and you shall call his name," you remember?
Zechariah.
No, Zechariah's son. Yeah, that's right, John. "And you will have joy. For he will be great before the Lord. He will be filled with the Holy Spirit, and he will turn many of the children of Israel to the Lord their God." Zechariah said, "How shall I know this? For I am an old man, and my wife is old too." And the angel said, "I am Gabriel. I stand in the presence of God, and I bring you this good news. And behold, you will not be able to speak until the day that these things take place, for you did not believe my words." The people were waiting for Zechariah, and they were wondering at his delay in the temple. And when he came out, he was not able to speak to them. And they knew that he had seen a vision in the temple. And he kept making signs to them, for he could not talk. And when his time of service was ended, he went home. Soon, Elizabeth conceived. She said, "The Lord has done this for me," and John was born. So when God promised to Zechariah and Elizabeth through the angel Gabriel that they would have a son, what happened? It came true. They really did have a son. And that shows us that we can trust in God's promises, because when he says something, it happens. So in the same way, when God promises that Jesus died on the cross for us, and that in our baptism, our sins are washed away. And then when God promises that he wants us to live with him in heaven forever, we can trust in those promises. We know that God is telling the truth. Because let's do the actions. Because you can trust in God's promises. Awesome. Okay, I'm going to pray for us. So please bow your heads, fold your hands, and close your eyes. Heavenly Father, thank you for sending your angel to Zechariah with good news. Help me believe the good news that Jesus is my Savior. Amen. All right, thanks so much for coming up, boys and girls. You can go on back to your seats.
We continue with our responsory, which is found at the bottom of page 221. The bottom.